Good morning, students. Today we will do the sixth chapter of your book, Daffodil, and the poem name is The Bazaar of Hyderabad. Okay? So this poem is written by Stojni Naidu. She is the poetess of this poem. Okay? And through this poem, she is describing the various variety, various bazaars of Hyderabad. Clear? This poem is in front of question and answer, means through the questioning and through the answering, she is telling each and everything what is found in the bazaars of Hyderabad, which variety are there, and merchants, what are doing there. Through this technique, along with vivid image, with touch of all five senses, the poet makes the picture of bazaar visual, means she has tried to give a visual picture of the market of Hyderabad, of the bazaars of Hyderabad through this poem. And have you observed the typical Indian bazaar where vendors, street sellers sell their wares? How do you think they are different from today's supermarket? Nowadays, supermarket, okay? And in old days, there were bazaars. So through this poem, you can see which type of bazaars were there in our old time. And now how they are different to our supermarket. Clear? So let's see now. First stanza. What do you sell, O merchant? Richly your wares are displayed. Turbans of chrisman and silver. Tunic of purple brocade. Mirrors with panels of amber. And braggers with handle of jade. Clear now? So here, she is asking to the merchant, okay? My merchant, what you are selling? Which object you are selling? And she is saying, okay, your wares, your objects are displayed, like you are selling turban of dark red color, okay? Or silver. Tunic of purple color. Tunic, it's a name of outfit. Or you can say, veshbhusha. Mirror with the panel of amber. You can mirror, and there is boundary of amber. What is the meaning of amber? Fossil tree green. Like you have seen, it is amber. Clear now? So dagger with the handle of jade. Jade, what is the meaning of jade, beta? Ornamental mineral. Clear? It is green color stone, and it is used for making jewelry or decorative item. Dagger hota hai khanjar. So that merchant is selling what? Dagger with handles of jade. I hope it is clear to you. Then she is going to vendors, and she is questioning to the vendors that what they are selling. What do you weigh? What do you weigh means what you are weighing, or tum kis cheez ka weight kar rahe ho? Vendors, and saffron and lentil and rice means you are weighing saffron. Saffron kya hota hai beta? Kesar. Lentil, dal, jaise moong masoor koi bhi dal ho, or rice. What do you grind? Tum kya pees rahe ho? Oi maidens, maiden servant. Female servant is called maiden. And sandalwood, and she is replying, I am grinding sandalwood, hina and spice. Sandalwood hota hai beta? Chandan. Chandan ki lakdi, and hina, mehendi, you know very well, spice, masale. What do you call a peddler? Jasmine and ivory dyes. Then she is asking to peddler, what you are selling, and he is replying, I am selling jasmine. Jasmine jo mohare hoti hain, jisse hum chess khelte hain, ivory dyes, aur aapne dekha hoga while you are playing the ludo, then one dice is there that is made of ivory. Next you can see, what do you make, O goldsmith? Then the poetess is going to goldsmith. Goldsmith with Devita Sunar. And she is asking to the goldsmith that what you are doing. And he is replying, I am making wristlet. Wristlet, bajwan. And anklet. Anklet with payal. Ring, anguti. Bells for the feet of blue peasants. आप देखा होगा जो कबूतर होते हैं उनके पैरों में भी क्या है पाजेब्स होती हैं उनको बोलते हैं बेल्स फॉर द फीट ऑफ ब्लू पिजन्स एंड फ्रेल एज ड्रैगन फ्लाई विंग्स व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ इट इट मींस द बेल्स व्हिच the goldsmith is making, that is so lightweight as the wings of dragonfly. Okay, now you can see girdles of gold for the dancer. Girdles so the beta kamarband. I'll show the picture also while I will take your zoom classes. And scabbards of gold for the king. Scabbards होते बेटा sheath. Sheath means mayan. Mayan क्या होती है जिसमें तलवार को डाला जाता है. What you are making? You are making sheath. You are making girdles or you are making bell bracelet. So she is questioning to that goldsmith. Next she is going to the fruit seller and she is asking, what are you selling? Okay, and the fruit man is replying, citron, pomegranate and plums, these all are fruits name. What do you play, oh musician? Then she goes to musician and she is asking to musician, what you are playing? And you are playing on sitar, sarangi or drum. What do you chant? Then she goes to musician and she asks to musician what you are chanting. And she is asked, then musician reply, what he replied? He replied, I am chanting for the divine power. Here is written a spell for the eon. Spell for the eon means I am chanting for the divine power. Now you can see the last para. In last para, she goes to a flower girl. Okay, and then she is asking to that flower girl, what you are doing, what you are weaving. Weaving hota beta bunna with tassel of ozé and red. Here ozé means deep blue color. Okay, and tassel means flower. So she is asking to the flower girl, what you are weaving with the deep blue flowers. And she is replying, crown for the brow of bridegroom. She is asking, are you making the crown? Crown hota beta taj. Are you making the crown for the bridegroom? Chapel for the garland, his bed, or you are making the chapel? Chapel the sheet of flowers for decorating the bed of bride and groom on first night. And the sheet of white blossom you gathered to perfume the sleep of dead, means while a person has been dead, then for decorating his last bed we put white color flower sheet. Okay, you are weaving that sheet, you are weaving chapel, you are weaving garland, what you are weaving? She is asking to that. So by these questioning and answering, she has described the complete view of bazaar of Hyderabad. I hope you have understood each and everything. Now tomorrow I'll make you write the question answer in word meaning of this poem. Have a good day to all.